हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इट इज आईएएस कन्नड वाहिनी। एज यूजुअल इट इज आईएएस क्वेश्चन पेपर एनालिसिस, दैट इज मॉडल क्वेश्चन पेपर एनालिसिस कंटिन्यूस। सो टुडेज क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट वंस अगेन अबाउट द इंडियन पॉलिटी, दैट इज मेनली ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। टुडे वी हैव गिवन अ सिंपल क्वेश्चन। क्वेश्चन इज ए जज गेव अ डिसीजन 6 टाइम्स अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट इन 10 केसेस, that is in the verses of like state versus citizens. According to the constitution, the president under the circumstances, under these circumstances, would, means what is the action he can take. I have given one example, that is imaginary example, like a judge gave a decision 6 times against the government in 10 cases, that is state versus citizens. According to the constitution, in same situation or in under such a situation, president can, what he can do about this judge. Like the first answer option is put the judge on trial. Second, refer the judge's case to the parliament. Next, declare the judge's decision null and void. Take none of the above measures. So among the four options, you are supposed to answer. So what is the constitutional procedure for the removal of the judge of the High Court or Supreme Court? That comes under, for example, if we take like the judge of the Supreme Court, it comes under Article 124. The president can pass an order for the removal of the judge after an address by the joint houses of the parliament passed in total majority or like total membership of the majority, on the grounds of like proved misbehavior and incapacity. So in given question, proved misbehavior or incapacity is not substantiated or it is not proved. Therefore, president cannot remove judge on this ground. So automatically, obviously, the answer will be take none of the above measures. The president can remove the judge of the Supreme Court or High Court only on the address made by the parliament, that is passed with majority of the total membership of the house, then only he can remove. Therefore, D is the answer. In some times, like judicial powers of the president, the terms explained what I mean. The president has got the power to appoint the, you can select the judge of the Supreme Court, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, as well as the judge of the High Court. But he cannot remove. Removal is somewhat different. Why this clause has been incorporated? The reason is there is a checks and balance between legislature and judiciary, executive and judiciary. Executive can appoint the judicial authority, but judicial authority can be removed only after the address by the parliament. So this is how like the checks and balances are maintained in our parliamentary democracy. Already I have explained that is impeachment of the judges. The impeachment of the judges can be done only after an address by the each house of the parliament, supported by the majority of the total membership of that house and by the majority of not less than 2/3 members of the house present and voting has been presented to the president. Then on the grounds of like proved misbehavior and incapacity, he can be removed. So that is the impeachment of the judges. That comes under Article 124. The impeachment of the judges comes under Article 124. Then, under Article 141, the president can seek the opinion of the Supreme Court on the matter of law, on the matters of law or fact. He can see any kind of suggestion, opinion on the matter of, you can like law point or law matter. And judicial cases versus president means any judge who gives the so many judgments, it doesn't have any direct relation with the, you can say, like kind of executive action. That is pros and cons. Based on the pros and cons of the cases, the judge will deliver his decision. So it has not directly related with the action of the president. Therefore, it is totally irrelevant. So answer will be D,